Sir, bago tayo magpatuloy, nais ko lang sabihin na bossing ko vlogger na. So subscribe to his channel, okay?
Walang hirap.
ang latest topic niya, JNT, basketball team. Sir, later ha. Ang boss.
Kumusta? Jayagonoy po, keepsakes. Yung nakita nyo kanina, yun palang sabihin na tinawag natin na ambush. Oo, mukha siyang ambush na hindi. Pero oo, siguro pagkatapos itong lahat naman nangyayari sa quarantine, pati yung bossing ko, nag-YouTube na. So, content creator na rin si bossing. Kaya, please follow nyo. Isa sa mga videos na ginawa niya is about JNT Express. Alam mo yun, may mga lessons dun sa JNT Express incident. So it's time for another recap. And yes, we have a list of things to mention here. Itong listahan na to is VTuber recap. So yeah, dun tayo magsimula. So, Sabado, last week, Kiryu Coco released her 3D model. Pinanood ito ng 5,000 viewers sa YouTube. At yung mga super chats, kung bibilangin mo, umabot siya gross 2.5 million pesos. Ang laki na noon. Isa pa sa importanteng bagay na kailangan malaman natin sa 3D stream na to is that one, isa to sa mga pinaka-entertaining na 3D debuts so far na napanood ko. Kasi to make up for the lack of interaction between Coco and her colleagues sa hololive, siguro nanonood sila, siguro pinagmamasdan nila kung ano ba tong 3D stream na to. Eh, Coco set the benchmark again for another entertaining stream. As much as she has set her own standard in entertaining people at 6 in the morning, doing streams basically almost every weekday kung okay siya. Most of the time naman okay siya, pero sometimes hindi. Pero moving on, Coco's a very interesting VTuber. Hindi mo malaman kung saan ka ipupunta ni Coco sa mga kung anong pinaggagawa niya. Nandiyan na ma-ban na siya, tapos ma-resurrect uli siya uli, mabigyan uli ng rights to stream live, mga ganon. And then, yung nag 1 week break siya, nangangati yung mga tao, gusto nila makapanood ng asa Coco, but they have to suffer and watch replays, mga ganon. And, you know, yung entertaining na stream niya, yung cliffhanger doon is yung gusto niyang maging idol na. Nag-decide siya, sige, magiging idol na ako. Kinanta niya yung Shiny Smile story. And perhaps, siguro, yun yung official, unofficial English translation ng Shiny Smile story na, of course, all Hololive Idol project members have sung it in their swimsuits at the beach. If that's the way to make Hololive Indonesia sing SSS, I'm in it. Or maybe they can just translate SSS to fit in for the Indonesian vernacular, which is ginawa ng NIJISANJI Indonesia. You know, the 3D debut stream has been so overwhelming that I need to take a drink. Really, really. Doon sa references niya sa mga Yakuza, talagang kung makikita mo, solid na Yakuza otaku itong si Kiryu Coco. Kaya props to Kiryu Coco. Mabalik tayo dun sa 5K viewers na yun. One of them was watching from a computer, a laptop, at an appliance store in Singapore. Mad dedication. Absolute mad lad. Next up, HAACHAMA, stuck in Australia kasi bawal pang bumiyahe pabalik ng Japan for like a year. A year. Hindi ko alam. Pero kung ano na pinaggagawa ni HAACHAMA, talagang quality HAACHAMA quality yung ano, yung pinaggagawa niyan eh. She's starting to learn everything herself. Magluto or hindi magluto. Ewan ko. Tapos puro mga kung ano-ano lumalabas sa bibig niya. Someone help her, guys. Hindi yun maganda. So nasobran siya ng HAACHAMA. Baka naman painumin nyo naman ng kaunting asa Coco. Baka naman, pwede naman. Okay, so next up, Yozora Mel has returned to streaming and sinong bumulaga sa kanya? Si YouTube. Ban. Tagal ding nawala ni Mel. So, ang daming nagbago. Yun nga, yung kagaya nung panahon na nag-stream si Kairo ng birthday stream niya tapos biglang naglabas ng toy gun and then sabi ni YouTube, oops. Tapos, nakita nyo naman si Mel, kakabalik pa lang niya sa YouTube after, you know what, a long time. And, really, ang bumulaga sa kanya is YouTube-kun who says, Mare, baka naman. By the next stream, ang dami na niyang pinagagawa. Sometimes, may saltik talaga tong YouTube AI na to. Kung hindi ka ibaba ng stream, kung hindi ka ibaba na mag-live, kung hindi ka ibaba na mag-upload ng videos or te-terminate yung account mo, ewan ko kung ano standard ni YouTube. AI siya eh. And in this time of pandemic, talagang AI yung nagpapagalaw on most of the content moderation sa YouTube. It's really hard times. Kagaya yung nangyari kay Ratapiti. So, yeah. Okay, so my new wave daw sa hololive. And here's a teaser. If you look at it closely, ang ganda ng character design. We look forward to that in the next few weeks, I guess. Tapos tignan mo naman itong si Hughes, gawa ng mga sketches. Sketch lang ng sketch ng hololive. Walang kapaguran niya si Hughes eh. Based Hughes yan eh. You do not question Hughes and his choices. Peko. Moving on to NIJISANJI, I attended Creator Super Stream last Friday. Yung unang araw nila is virtual day. And of course, host sila doon sa buong event. So we got HAACHAMA, Azea Cornelia, and then ang guest nila, of course, is Hololive Indonesia, the trio. And, well, to tell you my experience attending the Creator Super Stream Volume 2, watch the next segment. So, Creators Super Stream by AFA. This is an Indonesian event. I'm going to try and attend this event. So, let's see if I can go with this. Virtual day, 7 p.m. Ay, so lupit ah. Hosted by NIJISANJI Indonesia. So, mga host sa Creator Super Stream are from NIJISANJI Indonesia. So, I think I got the virtual day ticket na. So yes, successful yung transaction. Really now, I can actually do this. It's already 9 minutes before Creator Super Stream starts. And I'm going to multitask. I'm multitasking with the technical rehearsal for Toycon TV, which will be coming out of the day following. Ano? Sabay-sabay sila lahat, Lord. So, how do I divide myself?
Okay.
So far in my lifetime, I believe that there are 3 Japans. Japan, Taiwan, and Indonesia. Because basically, the cultural boom and the cultural impact of Japan has spread upon Taiwan and Indonesia. Of course, there's more to it, but we're just going to one aspect of it, which is Indonesia. And in Indonesia, they have the Creator Super Stream Volume 2, in which tonight is the VTuber night. So I'm going to watch VTubers. The reason is basically Ayu the Risu. She's the reason, and I'm the reasoner. Well, of course, recording is not allowed in these kinds of streams. You know, AFA. And that said, of course, you can see that it's blurred. So far, watching Indonesian VTubers is an amazing experience, especially that you actually paid for this, to watch this, and it's really possible that online events like the Creator Super Stream can actually ask people to pay. Wado! May teaser din ang NIJISANJI Indonesia on who will be the next 3 VTubers under their umbrella. Which means tatlong VTubers ang madadagdag sa NIJISANJI ID. And one of them is very, very relevant sa community, ano? Because her costume, her character design, pang tokusatsu. She must be really one of those diehard tokusatsu fans in Indonesia. Take note, nagkaroon ng tokusatsu series na talaga masasabi mo, ah, that came from Indonesia. Bima Satria Garuda. And it had a second season. So, for a total, the series had 100 episodes broadcast on Indonesian TV. Which is parang, hindi natin natapatan yun ah. Lugi tayo dun ah. Okay, another one. I stumbled upon a post at the VTuber Appreciation Group on Facebook, and I saw this photo of a VTuber who's still going while she's pregnant, and that's interesting. Of course, there's a common argument na yun nga, the idol argument uli, na idols are pure, and so it will apply in the VTuber context. Pero this one, I don't think there's anything negative about it. Eh, happy siya sa kanyang ginagawa. We already have mommy VTubers and daddy VTubers, and that's fine. That's fine. That's absolutely fine. You do you. You do you. And for the last part of our VTuber recap, Lyrica, you know, the Canadian Filipino VTuber, aka former magical girl, aka old soul, kasi kinakanta yung mga Jukebox hits. Pinoy na Pinoy eh. Pag kumakanta ng Jukebox hits, tapos ganyan eh. But absolutely Pinoy. That's one Pinoy thing about her.
Kapalaran. Napakasakit. Nasaan na si Jupiter to? Ay, old soul pala tong si Lyrica. Oo naman. Okay, sakit ng iyong pagdating. Pagalis mo'y sadyang kay bilis din. Ang pagsinta ko ay sadyang kay sarap.
Eh, nakipaglaro siya ng Tetris sa mga viewers. Well, what happened is I found a new way to play Tetris, and I'm practicing it at the moment. So, yeah. TETR.io, or you can say it Tetrio. Because those at the website, they get easily disconnected if they have poor internet connection. So, other updates. Ako yung nagbinyag sa unang episode ng Conversations with Red Mendoza. You know, that guy from Anime Pilipinas and the Manila Times. He's covering the health kit right now, and I'll give you a snippet of what we talk about. Keeping yourself relevant is the name of the game right now. Attention is the name of the game. We are in the age of content, and now we are traveling in the land of attention. Marami, there are many distractions, like hololive, VTubers, NIJISANJI, tapos ito naman mga online events na to, and then there's the online ads, and then there's more VTubers, and there's more VTubers.
Oo. Totoo. And, with all due respect to the organizers, ha, at least ToyCon and Cosplay.ph are doing more video right now.
Well,
iba nga lang yung atake. Iba yung atake. Si ToyCon, they want more live. They want more interactivity.
Current content.
They want more people to react, to share the experience. Sa Cosplay.ph, what they're doing is they repurpose their content para na may konting relevance pa rin.
Nostalgia.
Para ma-remind natin, ma-remind yung mga tao na this is how events are held. At least nandun pa rin yung feel na you were there, the type of feeling na you were there. Mm-hmm. You were part of that event. Doon naman sa mga hindi nakaka-attend, ito pala yung nangyayari. Then of course that musical tribute na ginawa nila.
You wrote it for the time. And this is not just a thing in the Philippines. It's also happening in Malaysia, in Indonesia. Yun nga. In Malaysia, there's this event called Cosplay Commuter na hinuhold like every year physically. And then they repurpose it to become Cosplay Computer. In Singapore, AFA United, we both watched that, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Indonesia, AFA United. Super stream. And then there's many more events.
Yun nga, I hope other organizers, other organizers should also look into how online, of course online now is the new normal right now. Until such time we will be allowed to do events again.
If I may add, in Cotabato, they held their Cotabato toy show online. Mm-hmm. Tapos they talk about cosplay. Mm-hmm. In Bicol, the Otaku Bloodline Guild has transformed their Ani Gaiden into a live Facebook Live. So,
there are many possibilities online. It's just a matter of guts.
Oo. Guts and, of course, yung... Not just only guts, pero yun nga, yung content na may papakita mo. And of course, the platform where your content will be shown. There are a lot of platforms available right now. Facebook Live, Twitch, YouTube. StreamYard, YouTube, Zoom.
Like this one.
Ito. So, yeah. Napakarami. The possibilities are endless until we are so certain about how are we going to hold physical events until next year. Maybe siguro all our organizers should think about creating content. Kasi alam naman natin, the people are bored right now with the lockdowns. People are bored right now at their homes and they want something to be entertained with.
And yes, there's a lot of videos yet to be shown, yet to be released, pero maghintay lang kayo, darating din tayo dyan. And with that said, my name is Jay. Salamat po sa panonood and hope you enjoyed this video. If you do, like, share, subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to always ring the bell para hindi kayo maka-miss sa mga ginagawa natin dito sa Keepsakes. And also, yes, since na-mention ko na to before, anchor.fm/keepsakes every Mondays, 9 a.m. every 2 weeks. Podcast, conversations. We're going to start our recording for the podcasts for July and it will be very interesting. So, yeah, that would be it for me. Salamat po sa mga nanood. Jayagonoy po, Keepsakes.